2013, hardly anyone was able to see Don Coscarelli's John dies at the end on the big screen. The American production from 2012 with an R rating had a budget of less than $1 million and made $140,000 in the US, running on 19 selected screens. It was not a success, but probably not a failure either. As an independent production for which there was hardly any advertising or marketing, the movie is not subject of the usual calculation. And during release, it appeared also on DVD, Blu-ray and video on demand. So I don't have a clue what it really pulled back. It's based on the same named novel by Jason Pardjian, under his pen name David Wong, which started in 2001 as a comic web series, 2004 as a web novel, and since 2007 also available in a printed version.
Hello there, my name is Jason Pardjian. I write as David Wong, which is a fictional person I created in order to avoid paying taxes. I just wanted to thank you and to give you an early look at the new book I have coming out this fall called Futuristic Violence and Fancy Suits. It's a deeply personal tale that deals with an issue that I think touches the lives of millions of Americans, which is the threat of cybernetically enhanced supercriminals roaming the streets and killing people with their magical powers.
The complex and nested book is about Dave, who tries to convince a reporter to publish his story. He tells him about several times in which he and his best friend John are fighting beings from other dimensions, triggered by a drug named Soy Sauce. 2012 saw the sequel This Book is Full of Spiders, in which the story continues. This time it is about spider-like creatures that turn people into zombies.
If you don't know who I am, that's perfect. That means you didn't read the previous book in this saga, which, to be frank, doesn't paint me in the best light. I'm pleased to have this fresh opportunity to try to convince you I'm not a shithead. Gross.
With two more sequels in 2017, What the Hell Did I Just Read? And 2022, if this book exists, you are in the wrong universe. Parallel to the John Dies at the End series, Pardjian published the two books in the Zoe Ash series. 2015, Futuristic Violence and Fancy Suits, and 2020, Zoe Punches the Future in the Dick. The author posted his first story online for years for free, until fans persuaded him to make a printed version available, which he then produced in a tiny edition. One of these few issues was ordered out of pure coincidence by director Coscarelli, who then in 2007 directly secured the filming rights, leading to the novel being picked up by a publisher. David Wong meets a reporter in a diner.
David Wong? That was off there.
Look at the box.
Whose initial doubts about David's story of strange beings went away when David shows him one. Thanks to a drug called Soy Sauce, Dave and his best friend John are able to see invaders from a different dimension, which they fight also in the past and future, since time passes no longer just in one direction. Don Coscarelli sees also the retrospective
Phantasm.
Das Böse.
Work for budgetary reasons with more or less unknown actors. He also co-produced, wrote the screenplay and took part in the editing for this independent project. The unusual, very interesting soundtrack from Brian Taylor contains gloomy score and is, like the movie, not mainstream and very enjoyable if you get used to it.
Someday you will face the unimaginable. It is physically impossible to avoid it.
You got my attention, Mr. Wong.
This black stuff, this sauce.
You can see things you shouldn't be able to.
If I show you what's in this container, you'll never feel at one with the human race.
I realized all at once, my one chance to save the universe lay inside this bottle.
It'd be opening doors to other worlds, man.
What is that stuff, John?
The soy sauce?
That stuff.
I'm remembering things that haven't happened yet.
We were chosen by the soy sauce.
So you guys are what? Some kind of spiritualist exorcists?
It's something like that.
The director of Phantasm.
I'm Bubba Hooter.
I suppose you are wondering where you are.
I'm gonna guess we're in an alternate universe of some kind.
When I discovered John dies at the end by pure luck, he became directly part of the famous short list and is almost the newest entry. Movie and novel are both very good and differ in many points a lot, but not in the essential statement. The movie is missing important characters such as the former girlfriend of Dave. Some have much smaller roles and different names, like the dog, but others like Marconi get much more important. Some storylines are missing and relationships, such as with Dave and Amy, seem like out of the blue. Also, the book contains a further resolution which does not appear in the movie. John Dies at the End is a real secret tip. The story is exciting and the setting fantastic. Very well cast even in the supporting roles. It is consistently entertaining and keeps the fast pace to the end. From my point of view, Coscarelli's best movie. Probably so unknown due to the lack of $1 million budget for marketing and sales. And as an R-rated independent production, it is similar to Cube. With movies like this, it's a small miracle that they even exist. And the chance to see one of those in the cinema is smaller than finding the door that leads out of the cube. Or the reason why some critics have rated it so badly. While unimaginative garbage for the masses, even in the hundreds reincarnation, is praised to the stars and far beyond.